This is the finished look that I have. I think it's a really awesome way to wear red. I know colorful smokey eyes are really big on the runways and things like that. And while I don't believe in following trends necessarily, I do like this one. I like colorful smokey eyes. I think they're really fun to wear. So this is an easy way to wear red if you're kind of afraid to do it, since it is deepened with the black in the crease. I just feel like it's not too overpowering. So I hope you guys enjoy and stay tuned. I already did my foundation concealer. I did like the clover color corrector as my concealer. I did creamy peach as my foundation. And I used the e.l.f. under eye concealer under my eyes and just the e.l.f. primer on my actual eyes. So that's what I did already. We're gonna start off with a black base. I'm just using the e.l.f. cream eyeliner in black. You do have to kind of work a little quickly with this because it sets pretty quickly. But it's a really nice dark black base, and it doesn't crease very easily, which is why I like to use it as a base. It sets up really nicely. If you use like a Kohl eyeliner or something like that, it can smudge pretty easily underneath your eyeshadow, which you don't want. So I'm using my foiled again foiling medium. I like to shake it after I like to shake it every time before I use it. It mixes the glycerin and the water. But like I said, you can make this at home yourself. It's just 3 parts distilled water to 1 part vegetable glycerin. So if you want to make it yourself, that's fine too. I'm just using like 2 drops of it. If you do make it yourself, just make sure you make it in small batches, because without preservative, it'll go bad within a couple weeks. So and then we're just mixing in our pigment, and it's the red triangle pigment from the Christmas in Gotham collection. We're just going to put that on top of the black. See how that's just going to deepen it and bring out the intensity of the red? That's a good trick if you want to bring out intensity of colors. Just put them on top of a dark base and it'll make it look a lot more vibrant. I mean, this doesn't always work if you use the pigments dry, but if you do it wet, it'll work really well on top of the black. Okay, we're gonna let that dry a little bit. And now I'm gonna go in with a matte taupe color. This is Urban Decay Shakedown. And we're going to put that through our crease with a fluffy blender brush. Blend it upwards a little bit at the end. And this will give us a nice base to blend the red out onto. We're going to blend the red with the dry pigment on top of this. A little bit of that red triangle pigment, the dry pigment, and blend that into that brown color. And this is just like a red smoky eye. Something kind of different. If you're feeling sassy or saucy or whatever. And like I said, I've been really loving red eyeshadow lately. I think people are afraid to use it because I think it'll make them look tired. But I think you'll see at the end of this look that it really doesn't appear that way at all. It's really just how you blend it out and the colors used to deepen it. And colorful smoky eyes are really in for the fall and winter too. If you look at the runways. Take a little bit of Dark Side from the Christmas in Gotham collection. It's that really dark matte black base with the gold shimmer in it. And we're just taking the e.l.f. contour brush. And you want to be careful with this color, since it is black, We want to tap off as much as we can into the lid and do this slowly just to avoid any fallout problems. Like I said, we're doing this gradually so we don't get a lot of fallout. Because blacks are notoriously hard to fix if you get a bunch of fallout on your face. And we're going to flick it up a little bit in the outer corner, especially if your outer corner droops a little bit down like mine does. I like to flick up a little bit to give that illusion that the eye is going upwards. It has more of like an almond shape. A little bit more of that black to the very outer corner, just to deepen it super black. Okay, and then we're just gonna go on top with our fluffy brush and just blend that in a little bit. And this is just going to make it really polished looking. Just blend all over. It almost gives the black kind of a super dark brown look a little bit. So blending it in with the red. Flat synthetic brush. It's the e.l.f. concealer brush, and we're going to use Ice Princess as our highlight. I think this will be really fun because it has a little bit of an orange and red duochrome to it. So in the light, it's going to have a hint of that red, which is going to look really nice with the rest of the look. It's going to blend really well into that red. It's got a pretty amount of, it's got a really pretty shimmer in it too. Which will look nice and dramatic with this look. Because I envision this more as like a holiday party kind of look. Something you'd wear out. Although, I mean, if you want to wear it at home, it doesn't matter. I like to wear these kind of looks when I'm home too. I like to get the most amount of color right below the brow. And that's why I like using this kind of a brush, because you can just really get in there and saturate that color. We're going to do our upper waterline with the Urban Decay 24/7 Zero Pencil. We're going to get our lower as well. Just like the outer third though, we're not going all the way in with it. Take a little bit of dark side on an angled brush with a little bit of foiling medium, and we're going to use this as an eyeliner on our upper lash line. Stay pretty close to the lashes. We'll do our brows with a little bit of that shakedown color. I mean, just do your brows however you normally do them. I just like to use a shade that matches my brows or is a shade lighter. And that color works for me. Just get it through the arch. And I already groomed my eyebrows too. I just used an eyebrow brush to get them all to stay in place. Because I am growing out my brows a little bit thicker, so I have to be careful to make sure I groom them. But thicker brows actually do make you look a little bit younger, which is nice if you're in your mid-20s like me. I'm thinking I'm going to call it like red and black licorice, because that's kind of what it reminds me of a little bit. We're going to take a little bit of Selina, which is that bronzy color from the Christmas and Gotham Collection. Trying to use colors that are all in that collection, so if you do end up getting it, you can create these looks with the colors you have. And plus, I just love this color. I'm putting that on a small precision brush, and I'm getting that on my lower lash line. We'll blend it out with a little bit of the red triangle. on the outer third. Take a fluffy brush and blend that in. Since this is a smoky eye, we're trying to smoke out everything. I don't think the eyes look too closed off since we did keep the inner half part clear of black eyeliner, so this look will work for people with smaller eyes as well. I'm going to go in with my Herbanluxe Volumizing Vegan Mascara. I really do like this stuff. You have to be a little careful. You get a lot of product on the brush. So if you're used to more of a lengthening formula, like, you need to be a little more careful with this one, because this is definitely like a volumizing one. Peach Sorbet, which is from my line. It's just a matte peach blush, so if you have one of those, that's fine. You can use that. This is what it looks like. And we're taking that on the e.l.f. powder brush or complexion brush and lightly getting that on our cheeks. And this is just going to warm things up a little bit, so it'll work with the rest of our makeup look. Blend that in. Really, I like to do a little bit at a time with the mineral blush because it's very pigmented and easy to overapply if you don't, which is not a bad problem to have. And that just adds a little glow. And this is in the Christmas and Gotham collection as well. It is the Miss Kitty lip gloss, and it's just a sheer red lip gloss with a little bit of silver shimmer in it. It's actually pretty wearable. And this is only available in the full-size collections right now, but I am working on developing a range of lip glosses for my line, so just keep that in mind. But I just want to make sure I have enough for the full collections at the moment. It has jojoba oil, castor oil, meadow foam oil, natural preservative that's certified for use in organic products, so no parabens or anything nasty in there. It also has shea butter, so it's like really moisturizing for the winter, which is what I like, and it's not sticky at all. It is an oil-based lip gloss, so it's not going to be sticky like commercial lip glosses. So you do have to reapply it a little bit more frequently than like a mineral oil-based lip gloss, but I don't mind that because this is something that you ingest. So if you're eating like the more chemical-based lip glosses, I mean, that's going into your body. So I kind of want to be careful about stuff I wear on my lips every day. So I think this is a wearable red smoky eye, and it's pretty easy to do. And yeah, if you get the Christmas and Gotham collection, you have all the stuff you need to do this look, really. So I will talk to you guys soon. And for right now until the 15th at midnight Central Time, I have free shipping on orders over $20. So if you want to take advantage of that, go ahead. And thank you to everyone that has supported the Christmas and Gotham collection so far. It's been really successful so far. I'm really proud, and I'm really happy to like come up with ideas for my next collection, which is going to be based on the movie The Labyrinth. So pretty excited about that. I'm like a huge David Bowie fan, and I love that movie. I've loved it since I was a kid, and I'm a big fan of Jim Henson movies. So I am excited, and I already have like a list of 20 colors I want to make, but I'm gonna have to pare it down, of course. But yeah, I'm gonna order the supplies for that pretty soon and start working on ideas. So yep, I am really excited about my line, and I thank you guys so much for supporting cruelty-free and vegan cosmetics. You guys are awesome. I'll talk to you soon. Bye.